Hello, Gators. This is 5.10, Introduction to Optimization Problems, and 5.11, Solving Optimization Problems. Let's take a look at how we optimize. The strategy is this: draw a picture, identify known and unknown quantities, write an equation that will be optimized, write your equation in terms of a single variable, determine the desired max or min with calculus techniques, determine the domain endpoints of your equation to verify if the endpoints represent a max or a min. So let's take a look at this first problem. We want to find two numbers whose sum is 30 and whose product is as large as possible. So let's go ahead and talk about these two numbers. Two numbers whose sum is 30, and we want to find the maximum product. Now, the maximum product is P is equal to X times Y. Now, we know that we have two variables here, so let's see if we can get it into one variable. Y will be equal to 30 minus X. So this was going to be X times 30 minus X, or 30X minus X squared. Now, if this is the case, remember, the two numbers, the sum is 30. So X can actually, if the sum is going to be 30, it can be as small as 0, or it can be as large as 30. So that's what the X can be. If the sum is 30, either X is 0, and then the other number is 30, or X will be 30, and the other number is 0. All right, let's go ahead, and now we have our product in terms of X. So we're going to take the derivative, and that'll be 30 minus 2X. We're going to set the first derivative equal to 0, and that means X will be equal to 15. Now, that is a critical point, so what we want to do is we want to take the second derivative, and that'll be negative 2, which tells me that at the value 15, everything is always going to be negative. Negative means that I'm going to have a relative max, and that relative max is going to be 15 into this product right here. So that'll be 15 times 30 minus 15 squared. And that answer will be a relative max of 225 at X equal to 15, because P prime is equal to 0 and P double prime is less than 0. This is called the second derivative test. Now, I have found a relative max. Let's make sure I have found the absolute. Remember that if I allow X to be equal to 0, and if I let X equal to 0, then my product will be 0, and that product isn't very big. And if I let it be 30, and I put 30 in here, I'm going to get 0. So my endpoints are not going to give me any bigger number. So I have the answer. That is an absolute max of 225 at X equal to 15. Let's take a look at another problem. A rectangle has a base on the x-axis and its upper two vertices on the parabola. So draw a sketch. Here's the rectangle. It's sitting inside the parabola. And it's going to be in the middle. So there's going to be some symmetry here. So this length is viewed as X. And this height will be the height of the parabola. All right, we want to now set up a formula for the area. The area is equal to 2x times the height, which is y. And we want to get it in one variable, so my y will now be 12 minus x squared. So now I have my area in terms of one variable. Now this x, the smallest x can be, is 0. It can be right here. We have no rectangle at all, or touch all the way over to here. And that point is when when this is equal to 0, and that'll be equal to 2 root 3. Now, these endpoints here will not really give me a rectangle, So I know that my endpoints will not be something I want to look at. All right, so let's go ahead and multiply out. That's 24x minus 2x cubed. So this is going to be my equation. And I'm going to go to the next slide and show you my rest of the work. Okay, so what I did is I went ahead and I took the derivative and I found the critical points. And I chose to go to the second derivative test by taking the second derivative, evaluating 2. At 2, I have a negative value, which is a relative max. I went ahead and put 2 back into my function. I got 32. And I know this is 2. And I don't have to look at the endpoints because they will not yield a rectangle at all. Let's take a look at the next problem. We have a 216 square meter pea patch to be enclosed by a fence and divided into 2 equal parts by another fence right in between here. So we're going to call this part x and x because they're divided into equal quantities. And so these both will be x's here. These will be y's. We don't know what that dimension is. So we know that our area of this whole rectangle is 216, and 216 will be 2x times y, or x times y will be equal to 108. Now we're looking for the dimensions of the perimeter, all the fence here. So I'm going to call that perimeter. I want to add up all of the pieces of fence. So that'll be 4x plus 3y. And I'm going to want to substitute for y, and I'm going to substitute 3 times, and I'm going to solve for y here, and that'll be 108 over x. So this will be 108 over x, and now I have an equation in one variable, and that's 324 over x. I'm going to go to the next slide to show you the calculus part. And what I ended up doing was taking the derivative and setting it equal to 0 and finding my critical points, taking my second derivative, evaluating my critical point, got a positive. That means I have a relative min. I substituted 9 back into the original, got 72. And my justification, I answered the rest of my question, which is the dimensions and the amount of fence I need. Last problem, find the length and width of a rectangle that has a perimeter of 64 and a maximum area. So we'll call this x and this y, and we know the perimeter is equal to 64, which is equal to 2x plus 2y. So we can say 32 is equal to x plus y. We are trying to find the maximum area, and the maximum area is equal x times y. And if I substitute for my y, I'm going to have 32 minus x. And so here's going to be my equation. And we'll go to the next slide to see the calculus. And I can see I figured out my critical point, which is at 16. I evaluated my critical point at the second derivative, found that it was minus, substituted the 16 back into my area formula to get my relative max, located at 16, and my justification. And remember that these are the steps that we follow to do the problem.